Welcome everybody. Our paper title, Boundary Element Thermomechanical Modeling of Fractional Order Nonlinear Dual Phase Lag Bioheat Transfer Problems and Functionally Graded Anisotropic Viscoelastic Soft Tissue. The main objective of this paper is to contribute for increasing the development of biocomposite applications according to our boundary element modeling for describing thermomechanical interactions in functionally graded anisotropic viscoelastic soft tissues. The governing equations of current model are briefly presented, including the time fractional order nonlinear dual phase lag bioheat transfer model and BIOTS model. These highly complex governing equations are solved using the boundary element method, which is a versatile and strong method since it deals with more complex viscoelastic soft tissue shapes and doesn't require the discretization of the interior domain. Also, it has low RAM and CPU utilization. The general boundary element method based on local radial function collection method has been used for solving the time fractional order nonlinear dual phase lag bioheat transfer model. Then the displacement and the stress distributions can be achieved by solving the mechanical equation using the convolution quadrature boundary element method. Numerical results demonstrate the validity, efficiency, and accuracy of our proposed modeling technique. As in the introduction, a human body is a complicated thermal structure. Arsene de Senneval and Claude Bernard have been proved that the temperature difference between arterial blood and venous blood is due to oxygenation of blood. An important number of research papers in bioheat transfer over the past few decades has focused on an understanding of blood flow effect on the temperature distribution within living biological tissues. The first attempt to describe the temperature distribution in biological tissues with a blood flow effect has been introduced by Beniz, Askarizade, and Ahmadikia, solved analytically Fourier and non-Fourier bioheat equations. In skin tissue, Lee, reference number 4, established the biothermomechanical behavior in bilayered human skin. Due to nonlinearity of bioheat equations, it is very difficult to solve them analytically. In general, therefore, many researchers have used and applied various numerical methods like finite difference method, finite element method, and boundary element method. The boundary element method is one of the numerical methods used to solve the current general problem. Generally, Laplace domain fundamental solutions are easier to obtain than time domain fundamental solutions for engineering and scientific problems, since the convolution quadrature boundary element method requires Laplace domain fundamental solution of the problem's governing equations and didn't need unknown time domain fundamental solutions. Therefore, it is widely used and significant in scientific and engineering applications. Formation of the problem, the governing equation that models the biothermomechanical behavior of anisotropic biological tissues can be expressed as equations 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Implementation for bioheat transfer field of the problem. The three-dimensional bioheat transfer equation expressed by the following dual phase lag model. Equation 6. And the boundary and initial boundary conditions 7. Discretizing the time interval into f plus 1 equal time steps delta t with discrete times. Thus, equation 6 can be written in the system 8, which can be expressed in equation 9. According to the boundary element technique of Liao, reference 67, we can extend the technique to deal with three-dimensional dual phase lag bioheat transfer equation by considering the following partial differential equations 4, 5, question 10, 11, and 12. In order to obtain U, we follow the following iterative rules. Reference 68, question 13. Now we use boundary element technique for each transition to solve question 40. The boundary integral equation for 14 as in reference 62, equation 15, which can be expressed in equation 16. Equation 16 can be approximated as follows, equation 17. Using the boundary conditions into 17, we obtain the unknowns W and U on the boundary. Then the values U can be calculated as follows. Equation 18. Boundary element implementation for the elastic media. The representation formula for problem 7, which describes the unknown field U inside the domain. Equation 19. Where the integral operators are. Equation 20 and 21. The fundamental solution and the traction as a reference 65 was written in equation 22, where the solid displacement fundamental solution US can be expressed as in equation 23, which can be expressed as in reference 61 as in equation 24. For the regularization, the displacement fundamental solution for solid is dismantled into singular and regular parts respectively as in equation 25. Now the Laplace domain boundary integral equation can be expressed at equation 26. Apply inverse Laplace transformation to obtain the following boundary integral equation, 27, according to reference 65, Borrow elastodynamic fundamental solution can be expressed as in equation 28. By applying the procedure in reference 70 to the convolution operator of our problem 27, we obtain equation 29, which can be expressed at equation 30. Where the unknowns Newman datum is approximated with I continuous polynomial shape functions and the time dependent coefficients. Also the unknown Dirichlet datum is approximated with Gay-Piecewise discontinuous polynomial shape function of psi and the time dependent coefficients as follows. Question 33 and 34. Inserting these spatial shape functions into 30 equation yield the following algebraic system of equations, and we obtained the unknowns. Numerical results, this is the geometry of our problems, and this boundary element of our model. Variation of the biothermal stress with time for different graded values. This M equals 0 corresponding to homogeneous case. M equal 0.3, 0.6, 0.9 corresponding to graded parameters or functional graded material. Also here, this black means homogeneous, and this is for functionally graded material. Graded parameter 0.3, graded parameter 0.6, 0.9. Also here, black for homogeneous case, and these other cases for functionally graded materials. In order to verify our results and our technique, we compare our results with finite element method for a special case from our problem. We choose a special case for our problems and compare our results with boundary element results and finite element results. We found an excellent agreement for the results, which verifies the validity of our technique. The main objective of this article is to propose a novel boundary element model for describing thermomechanical interactions in an anisotropic viscoelastic soft tissue. The governing equations are studied based on the thermal wave model of bioheat transfer and the Biot's theory. These uncoupled governing equations are solved independently, where the bioheat transfer equation is solved first for obtaining the temperature distribution using the dual phase boundary element method, dual reciprocity boundary element method. And then the mechanical equation has been solved using the convolution quadrature boundary element method to obtain the displacement components for different temperature distributions at each time step. Due to the advantage of the considered boundary element method, such as dealing with more complex shapes of viscoelastic soft tissues and not needing the discretization of the internal domain, also it has low RAM and CPU USAC, therefore the BEM is a versatile and powerful method for modeling of bioheat distribution in anisotropic viscoelastic soft tissues and the related deformation. The numerical results show that the proposed BEM model can be used to treat tissues with large sizes or complex shapes under different laser modes. Numerical results demonstrate the validity, efficiency, and accuracy of the proposed model. Many thanks for all, and I hope success for this conference. Thank you.